Rishi, Ruthu,
hi.
Dr. Sandra.
Hi.
All these are aspirants. Probably you guys would be, few of you, all of you would be here few days down the line, few weeks down the line. That's the reason we do this session. Okay, so it's very important once you get the success, you come back and you be contagious enough to spread that success, to spread that aura. Because I've seen so many people, even these guys who are sitting on that side in Thane, yes. When Rohan Borges and the other guy, they never made, were giving them the speech. Okay. Actually, I had trouble them second time. They were in Thane last week, or actually last week in fact. And it's just that Tamil students were not able to. And it was difficult for all of them to accommodate. We already had 12 people there. Unfortunately, today, being Saturday, few of them are working. So we are recording. So if you better come now because, you know, recording something and listening to something and being there would be a lot of difference. Right? We can ask a lot of questions. We'll quickly understand more about their scores. Sandhya had been first. She was on our Wall of Fame. First, she had got listening 8.5. And reading and writing was 7.5. And speaking was?
2 8.5s,
yeah.
Rest
7.5s. Okay. And then Ruthu. Yes, Rooster. Ruthu and Rishi. She has got 9 in listening, 9 on 9. 8.5 in reading, writing 7, and speaking 7. Right? Okay. And he has also got 8.5 and
eight.
Reading, yeah, in listening 8.5, reading
8.
7, 7. And 7. So they'll quickly tell you about their stories. They have been part of her training programs and what they did. She was there for a very short period of time. They were there for more than the normal program. And they also wrote for the background test. They were initially unsure of it because of their professional life. It's very hectic for them. Just like you all have. Okay? So you probably will be able to relate to their hectic life and still believe that you can get to 8.59. So, I would start from Dr. Sandhya first.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, I will tell you how I got to know about my engineering skills. I was planning to sit for my IELTS and I was very confident that I would do very well and English is not an issue for me. So, I attempted at least 60 tests online and I was failing miserably. So, it wasn't good for my ego at all and these online tests, I was just not... Listening, I was just not getting any score. I was getting like 4 or 5, which was really pathetic. And reading also, I was not getting any score. And I'm a communication and English teacher, so it was not good. And I thought, what am I doing wrong? And I heard about mentoring angels through a friend. And they told me, go and you can speak to her and find out which way she can help. And when I met Pooja, obviously, the main thing which was a major influence in my scoring well was understanding that IELTS is just a very structured exam. It does not really necessarily test your English. It tests your ability to comprehend things the way they want you to comprehend it. So, speaking I was not much worried about. Because being in academics, you become sort of patient, so you can speak for a longer period of time. But I was very surprised that reading and listening was not happening. And the tips took me a while. I think in the first few sessions, I was here for a very short, I think 25 days.
Yeah.
I was here. And in those 25 days, first 1 week, I wasn't scoring well here also. And it took her also a while to understand what my problem area was. And in listening, the problem area was that I was too anxious to answer and too nervous that what the question is going to be and I'm going to miss it. And in that context, I would not listen to what the person is saying. And 99% of the time, the answer is right there. So in listening, what I learned was give it time. They don't speak fast, actually. They speak at a pace which you can comprehend. And you just have to concentrate a little. But most of the time my concentration was gone on the listening, so I would totally miss out on the answering part. And it would be gone in a flash. So that balance, was a big challenge for me. And I was very surprised that I got one of the higher scores in listening. So definitely improved from 4 to 8.5 is a big journey in 25 days. And that happened. So that was one challenge which I faced. The second was reading. And in reading, my challenge was that presumptuous, because I'm a voracious reader, I read a lot. And the minute you read, you start having these assumptions. The questions are going to be based on this, the questions are going to be based on this. And but again, it's a very structured format of reading and answering questions. It is very structured, and that enlightenment came through Pooja, because she told me, don't be in a hurry to read it like a story. There is a purpose for each paragraph, and you have to understand what that purpose is. As long as we follow the objective of each paragraph, and it's very defined. Once you get into the habit of reading it, you start making out from this paragraph, these are the kind of questions that are most likely will come. And the second tip that she gave was, read the questions if you can beforehand. So if you just read them a little, then you get a more clearer idea, and then you can concentrate on the paragraph. I was expecting I would get very good marks in speaking, but no, I got 7.5 there. Did not even touch 8, surprisingly. So that there goes the overconfidence part. One has to be very, very grounded, otherwise you misfire. And I think in speaking, I got very excited, because all the topics that she was mentioning were very interesting. She asked me things on perfumes and cooking and agriculture and food production and which is your favorite room in the house. So I would get carried away with explaining all of it. And the counter questions were equally more interpersonal and more customized. And I think I just slipped there because I got so excited about talking about one topic and maybe I missed out on the other topic and I could not balance it off. So I had a very great examiner for speaking. So she was very user-friendly. And but maybe somewhere I forgot that I'm sitting for a test, and I just started chit-chatting with her, which was not a very good idea. Probably if I would have stuck to the format, I could have done better. And writing, my biggest problem was handwriting is really poor, very, very poor. So Pooja even went to the extent of telling me, use pointy pencils, don't use blunt pencils, please sharpen them after every paragraph, because your sharpened handwriting with the pencil is much better than the, you know, blunt tip. So don't even think about these things. And how to rectify. I do blogging, so my thought process with blogging is very fast. I start writing, but again, writing also is expecting very specific things from you. So I would never think of things like connectors. Vocabulary, I can use fancy words, but the connector logic and how to structure each paragraph has its own structure, it has its own purpose in writing also, just like in reading. It took me a while to get used to it, and again, just 7.5. She changed the way I comprehend written and vocal communication. Being a communication teacher, it's different, but IELTS sensitized me to the nuances of reading and comprehending things. And when people are saying, so the importance of what you're saying and how you're saying becomes very different. Because when you listen, they say, okay, like, three out of two are there. So majority is there. Either they will say majority or they will say three out of two. If you say mostly, it's not the right term to use, right? So these small nuances, I became more fine-tuned to them. Now my lectures have become more tedious for my students, because I point out IELTS mistakes to them, but they aren't preparing for IELTS. So that's just a little. So I think structuring is what I would say. Be patient. When you know the answer, I have a tendency to get very excited. Oh, I know it. I can crack it types, and then you miss out on one of the small details, and everything matters. The more you put it in in a more structured way of things is important. Listening, they are not speaking fast. We are listening faster than they are speaking. Actually, they are not speaking fast. So for listening, that was because it was one of my weakest areas. I got 4 in when I was struggling with it. I understood when you're listening, just be calm. The answers are there. Pay attention, but don't pay over attention. Then you tend to miss out on answering totally. And if you just listen, you can. When I gave my exam, I missed out. But because I was listening carefully, I just went back and logically thought what would be the right answer, and surprisingly, it was right. So, if you are paying attention and if you are comprehending what they are saying, if you understand what is the flow of it, you can go back and probably give the right answer. It's not the end of the world if you just miss.